Hey, my name is Stephen Kochitsky, creator of Galicia Archives. In this video, we're going to go over how to find vital records from present-day Western Ukraine, which are Roman Catholic and Greco-Catholic, or Polish and Ukrainian, and we're going to do so using the Familysearch website. Now, if this video does prove helpful, please consider subscribing to the channel with notifications, liking and sharing the video, and leaving a comment in the comment section below. Okay, let's get started. Okay, this is the main page of familysearch.org. If you have an account with them, click sign in and it'll bring you to this page and you put in your login info. And if you don't, click on create account. It'll bring you to this page and you could sign up with these credentials or create an account by filling in the information. And the first box at the bottom, it's to receive church information. So odds are you probably won't want that. So you click on the second box and then click on done. Okay, so once you've logged in, you should come to a page similar to this. Now there are two things I want to show you. First, click on search and go down to catalog. Here, under place, this is where you want to type the name of the village or parish you're researching. I'm going to put Osovce, a village I've researched in the past, and you choose the one you want. Online. Search. One result, click on that. Metrical books 1835 to 41, Greek Catholic. And we scroll down through our list of results, in this case, one result. On the left, this is what the records contain. Here under film, this is the microfilm number and the item number, like a chapter number if you want. I'll show you what I mean in a few moments. And here we have a little camera icon. Now, had there been a key on top of the camera, it would have meant that the microfilm is locked and only accessible from a family history center. But in this case, there's no key, so it's accessible. Click on that, and we get into the records. Now you see here, this one, this means item one, or like I was saying, kind of like a chapter. And this is the end of that item or of that set of records. Then we start 2, 3, and we scroll down to 4. And here we go. So now double click on that. Osovce. Now here on the left, we have a plus and a minus. That's to zoom in and out. If we want to move the image, double click, hold and drag with the left key on your mouse. Here, it's for multiple image mode or single image mode. And here it's full page mode or full screen mode. So you click on that and you have a bigger image. Get rid of all that stuff up there on top. Now to scroll through the images, we use the arrows. Here, Greco-Catholic. And we keep going. And our records start, and we could scroll through them. Now to get out of here, we exit the full screen mode. And we go back using the arrow here on the left. And this brings us back to our list of records, in this case, our one single record. Had we had more records, well, we would have been able to go through all of them. Now, if we go back two more times, one, two, it brings us to our catalog where we could do another search, which I will do on the parish of Osovce, which is Petlikovce Stare. And here, if we go on top, there's a tab that I opened for you guys to show you. This is Osovce, and this is the parish, Roman Catholic parish. Online and search. Now, the reason I'm showing you this is so you know that if you don't find the village itself, always find out what the parish is. And I'll be coming up shortly with another video on that, which I'll try to attach to this video. Here we have metrical books 1707 to 1896, Roman Catholic. And as we scroll down, we have many, many records. Here, as I was saying, the key on top of the camera, it means the record is locked. And here we go. As of here, we have unlocked records, what they have or what they contain, the item number. So you have to scroll down, in this case, the item number 13, in this case, the item number 12. And it's kind of a hassle. So I'm gonna show you something different, another way. Both ways are good, and both ways I recommend to research. But if we go back to our main screen, to when we've logged on, and we go to search, and this time records, what you do is go down here where it says find a collection and type Western Ukraine. And here we go. And again, this is for both Polish and Ukrainian records from this area, Greco-Catholic and Roman Catholic. Click on browse all images, then click on Greek Catholic, and it brings you to a list of parishes. Now, just be aware of one thing. Here it's written Greek Catholic, but not all the records are Greek Catholic. I'm hesitant to say that it's a mistake in the system, so I kind of won't say that, but it's both Roman Catholic and Greek Catholic records, and these are all the parishes. I'll give you an example. Here, Mogilnica, Greek Catholic, but if we go in a record, we get Roman Catholic. So I'm gonna get out of here, Greek Catholic, to get to all my parishes. Now, let's say I wanna check for my Osovce. What I would do is the three dots on the top right-hand side, and I'm gonna do a find. A shortcut would be to just press Control Find. This is on a PC. By the way, I don't know what it would be on an Apple. And I put Osovce. And we have no results. So what I'm gonna do is now I'm gonna try to put the parish. And here we have Petlikovce Stare. Click on that. And now look the way we have our setup here. Each record, nicely identified, what they contain, the years. Click on that, the one you want. And you come to a small set of records. In this case, we have only 67 pages. You don't have to search for an item number. You don't have to go through a whole bunch, hundreds, before getting to the one, the set you want, or the ones that you want. And to get out of here, do not do back. Just click on Petlikovce Stare, and you come back to your list of records for Petlikovce Stare. So let's say I want 50 to 52. You click on that, and these are only records for 1950 to 1952. I mean 1850 to 1852, I'm sorry. And so on. So again, to get out of here, Petlikovce Stare. And if you wanna get out of Petlikovce Stare and back to your list of parishes, click on Greek Catholic, and it brings you to your list of parishes. And one piece of advice I could give you is here, once you're in this list of parishes, here the little star on top, click on that, keep it as a bookmark. I know I always do. And you always come back to this page quickly. You don't have to go through Familysearch and search for Western Ukraine and so on. Okay, let's do an example together now. I'm gonna close this. And here I have a passenger list. Let's look at number 10 together. Charkovsky Josef, he's 49 years old. On the top right-hand side here, 1913. So that means he was born in 1864. Here it says he's Polish, which means he was Roman Catholic. And here, Horodenka, the village he's from. His mother's name, Apolonia Charkovska. Let's see what we could do with this information. So let's go to our list of parishes. If you want, you could try this on your own, put me on pause. Control F, Horodenka. We have four results. Oh, here we go. And I click on the first one. 1864, we said, so 62 to 65. Let's try here. Roman Catholic, that's what we want. I'm gonna put it in full page mode. Another way to get out of here is, you see, if you bring your cursor on top, you have an X, so you could close that as well, not only using the toggle screen icon, and put it back into tile mode. And I'm gonna try to find 1864, which is, should be about 3/4 way down. Let me try this one. Oh, perfect, 1864. So let's find Joseph. No Joseph here. Next page. Oh, Joseph, there you go. Is it the right one? Tchaikovsky and mother's name, Apollonia. That's it. This is our guy. Now, if you want to save this page, you got to be careful, because if you zoom in, if you want to only have this information, you zoom into it and you do save as, you select where you want him. I like to put it on the desktop, and then I usually like to put the information of the person. So in this case, Joseph Tchaikovsky. He's from Horodenka. Birth, 1864. And save. Now, let's get out of here. I'm gonna minimize this, and let's look what we got. We don't have the full page, we only have that section. If you wanna have the full page, I'm gonna close this. Full page. You have to zoom out and make the picture full page, because it'll save what's on your screen and not the actual document itself. And if you do too much of zooming out, well, you see what happens. The words are not precise. You don't see them very well. No, I prefer zoom in until you have it nice like this, and that's it. Maybe get the topmost part of the page, or the 3/4 of the page, or you could even zoom in like this. If you're only interested on the information of this guy, and that's it. And then you do your save image as, and so on and so forth. Well, I hope the video was useful. I hope you got something out of it. Did it help you to find someone? If so, let me know in the comment section below. I'd really like to know. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.